Hello guys, welcome to something pretty new. This is about Misophonaria. This is a Misophonaria podcast, only with one person. Well, there's only, most of the time there is more than one people in the podcast, but I'm doing it alone. Okay, the first question about Misophonaria is, the final patch of Misophonaria will be the Siege of Orgrimmar. Both factions lay siege to the city to bring Garrosh down and end his reign of Warchief. That's what I really like. I hate Garrosh and I hate the Horde and I hate Orgrimmar. It's just perfect. As an Alliance member, I just want to see Orgrimmar burn. That's the only thing I want. The next one is, the new Elevar loot system will allow everyone to roll in individually, sorry for my language. The highest few rolls will win an item for the boss. Upon winning a roll, if the boss has an item that you can use, you will win it. If not, you will get some amount of gold. It will be in Elevar to begin with, but can be added to other parts of the game later. Well, that's what I really like. You cannot roll anymore for Elevar, just the class. With the gear, the class that the gear needs, they roll for that, and if you lose, you get a little amount of gold or something. Next one, an 11th character slot has been added. Yeah, of course, because there is a new class in Misophonaria. Move on. AoE looting has been added. That's what I really like. I'll be leveling a druid on WoW now, and it's a pre-expansion patch. You just kill a bunch of mobs, and then if you loot them, you just have like all the loot, the mobs together. That's really nice. No new race models are ready to be added yet. Well, that's a lie, because they said there is going to be new dwarven models. That's what they said. I don't know. I think that's a lie. There will be 9 level 90 heroics for players, as well as 3 raids with 14 raid bosses and 3 difficulties. There will be an additional 2 world bosses. Yeah. The world bosses, that's for, like, in Cataclysm, no one wanted to kill a world boss because it was so boring. You get, like, stupid gear from it. It's just stupid. They're just bringing back world bosses. I like that. It was in Vanilla, I think. I didn't play Mivalina. I played when Cataclysm came out. So yeah. Scenarios will take place at level 90. In an instance, reward reputation and valor points. You don't need a healer, tank and a DPS. Just DPS is fine. Each will take 10 to 30 minutes to complete and 5 or more will be available for launch. Yeah. The scenario part is more for like the people who like the lore of World of Warcraft. I like the lore of World of Warcraft too. So I probably, the scenario is going to be part of the story of the expansion, I think. Move on. In challenge mode, the vast majority of players will most likely earn a bronze medal, even if they are unskilled players. After a player earns all the medals at bronze level, they will be rewarded with an achievement and a title. Completing all silver medals will earn a set of spectacular gear for transmorphications, and completing all of the gold will earn a unique epic flying mount. Challenge mode will be available for the 6 new dungeons at launch. Yeah, challenge mode. I think that those are more for like the hardcore. I'm obviously going to try it, but Cloud Serpents are the Panarin's mount of choice. You can raise your own by doing 20 days of daily quests. Wow. Oh no, that's a grind. That's grinding that. 20 days of daily quests to raise your own Cloud Serpent. Well, I thought you can buy them, but they're not cheap though. You know the Cloud Serpents are like the Chinese dragons. Okay, the Tillers faction will let you run your own farm. The Farmer's Market will provide daily quests to improve your farm every day. You'll be able to clear plots of land and plant things like cooking ingredients, herbalism notes, gifts for NPCs to build your reputations, etc. Yeah, you can just build your own farm. That's really nice. That it's like I think it's gonna be really addictive because there was like one game in Facebook was all about farming, and you need to wait like for a plant like one day to grow, and then you can get like the cooking ingredients for it and herbalism things. But I don't have herbalism at all. And cooking too. I'm not like I only have like one profession that is full, and that's skinning. And little working is not even full, so I'm a noob. I don't like grinding. That's why. Okay, with all warlocks are the most class changes in WoW, along with the new pets. Okay, I saw them. They have like a brain sort of pet or something. I don't know, but it looks weird. There will be more mounts and less color swaps for different rewards. Nice. They are adding armor to creatures to give them varied appearances, something other than just simple color changes. That's good. I don't know what to say about that. It's just good. Move on. There are now 7 zones up from 5. This was done to add more content to the game and give players a less linear progression path, so that leveling for a second or a third time isn't the exact time. Okay. There will be one new arena and two battle pass at launch. Yeah. I'm not like a PvP hardcore player. Most of the time I'm a raider in a guild called Twilight Council. And I'm raid leader. We're not one of the best guilds though. We have one of the 8 heroic, but I want to push that guild to get to be one of the best guilds ever. And I just want to be the with the guild. It's not about, well, it's not only about raiding though for the guild. I like their friends. I like to be social with them, and that's what I like about guilds. I don't. It's not like only one main thing, and that's raiding. That's not what I think. It should be like that. It's not good. Don't think like that. It's just stupid. PvP battles are going to be fun and casual, only tracking the numbers of wins, not the number of losses. When fighting another player, you cannot see the other player's name or communicate. Oh, that's nice. So if you start a pet battle duel, there's no one around, you don't see anything. You cannot communicate, you just focus at the pet battle. They need to do that with the duels, and no one is in the way. You can just focus on your enemy and kill him. Why didn't they add that? It's one of the best things. Currently, every race except Goblin and Worm cannot learn the ways of the Monk. Yeah, I think that's obvious. Well, Goblins. I don't see Goblins doing Monk moves and all that. And Worgen, not at all. Imagine Worgen doing the monk style. Oh my god, they're already so retarded with their movement. But my main is a Worgen hunter, so the pre Mr. Malaya. Oh no, that's not. I need to skip that. Is there more questions? Let me see. There is a huge Horde vs Alliance storyline. The war between the Alliance and Horde heats up as they roll into Pandaria. It will serve as a major battleground, but things get so gnarly out of control. The war clans are committed by one side. It begins to spiral into Crazyville. Yeah. So what I've heard is the when at launch, Pandaria is just like really beautiful and all the hills and all that. But in the next patch, they say the Horde and the Alliance are gonna destroy Pandaria for its resources, that what they need, they can build like new technology and all that. That's the lore. What's more questions? Oh, what is this question? The expansion is not a joke. It's not light and fluffy, although Pandaria are fun and super zen. The conflict between Alliance and Horde is gearing up to hit a favorite witch unlike any we've ever seen. Yeah, monks. I mean, Pandaren. One of the first races who are neutral, who can choose between a lion and a horse. And some people might think, oh, they're just stupid, they're just from Kung Fu Panda and all that, but they're not, they're awesome. I bet them, they're just going to own you guys on every class, the Manka and Pandaren. Some say that the Pandarens are better as warriors because of their racial attributes. What more? I think it's all the question, I think. Yeah, I think it is. Talent system. No, nothing about that. Okay, guys, I think that's all the questions on the forums, I think. Thank you for watching. I hope you're excited, like me, for the patch. It's tomorrow. I mean, for the patch, for the expansion, of course. I pre-ordered it. And I'm just too excited. I would just want to play it now already. It's so good. Okay, guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and comment. And see you guys. Oh, wait. Oh, wait a second. When Myth comes out in WoW, new expansion, I think we're not going to upload like at least a week, no video, because we want to level our characters up to higher, we need to gear them and all that stuff, professions, or what else, reputation to get your enchants and all that, get gems and all that shit. Okay, guys, thank you for watching, and see you guys in the next episode. I mean, oh my god, not in the next episode, in the next video, and it's probably going to be a Mr. Pandaria video with me and Adam. See ya!